who have committed to include their artistic reflections on the Passion of Christ to help inspire Filipinos during Lent.
Well, joining us this morning to tell us more about the exhibit and his inspiration, artist Dan Lerma. Good morning to
you. Good morning.
Hello, how are you?
What's up, Doc?
What's up,
well,
Doc? Exactly.
We're here exactly about, to talk about Cristo Manila.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. This is exciting because you know, it's obviously we're right around the corner from Lent. Everybody is on a high because of the new Pope who has mm-hmm. been you know, proclaimed. So I think it's very timely actually to have an exhibit like this.
Yes, everything is in perfect timing. You know, we're entering into this holy season, mm-hmm. and you know how passionate Filipinos are about this.
Yeah.
And according to Cardinal Taglia, we in the Orient here are more of the sensing, feeling type mm-hmm. of people. So
right.
you know, everything comes into place.
Well, it's called Aman,
yes.
correct, Doc?
Correct. It,
which means believe, as
yes.
we've mentioned before. Why, you know, why Aman? Why that theme?
Well, we're trying to put this in context with the proclamation of this year's the Year of Faith by the Catholic Church, mm-hmm. and this supposedly started October of last year mm-hmm. and will end November this year. Incidentally, it's the opening coincides with the 58th anniversary of the Second Vatican Council mm-hmm. and the 28th anniversary of the proclamation of Catechism, promulgation of Catechism by the Catholic Church. And it ends in October where you celebrate the Solemnity of Christ the King.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, Doc, I mean, you know, Holy Week comes, of course, every year. I'm a practicing Catholic myself,
yes.
or I'd like to think, you know, I try to practice as hard as I can. How do you, there's such a challenge into kind of evolving how you develop your faith, how mm-hmm. you meditate. And in Cristo, there's a different way that we kind of look at the meditation part, right? That's through art. Tell us about that and
right.
this different take.
This year, about the Year of Faith, is actually we're touching on the wave of new evangelization.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, people keep on they have their own ways of searching for God, mm-hmm. and the church wants to be more sensitive about this thing because you know we have shifting paradigms nowadays. Mm-hmm. You have this secularism in Europe and North America, and the church, according to Taglia, should be humbler, simpler, with a greater capacity for silence. And so art is something like that, you know. It's kind of silent, but you have this audible voice speaking to you when you look at them. And it helps out, you know, in soul searching and you're going your own path and trying to look for God away from the beaten path, you know, which we usually know. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No,
well,
it's interesting rather that there are really we're in agreement. I think that there's so many pathways really to practicing
right,
your
right.
faith to,
mm-hmm.
to finding that inner peace that way to meditate over the teachings for the viewer and the artists who are taking part really in
mm-hmm.
in this exhibit. Tell us about some of the themes. Well, I know the overlying theme obviously is belief, but some of the themes in some of the pieces that you've brought here and some of the other pieces that the artists who are taking part are.
Yes, Paolo. Actually, the two pieces here we have are actually pieces from previous exhibits.
Mm-hmm.
The gallery doesn't allow us, you know, pull out
those
frames out of the exhibit while it's going on. It's not too good aesthetically. So right here, the theme last year was called So Be It.
Uh-huh.
So this is a piece which I made last year. It's called Amen of the
right.
Angel. So Be It, Amen. And this supposedly features these creatures of God where you have perfect obedience coming out of them. And this is some sort of a visual inspiration for us to try to follow the same path.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The other one is way back 2005. It's called Hope at Dawn.
Mm-hmm.
And I featured the Veil of Veronica where Jesus left his imprint. Bearing in mind that this leaving of an imprint bears another meaning, which means here, I'm leaving you with a sign that I'm coming back.
Right.
Okay, and then you see down there, you see the fisherman's boat. They seem to be waiting for dawn to break.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, the resurrection is pretty much, literally it happened at dawn, and it's pretty much saying this the news of a new life, you know.
Right.
Right.
Well,
Right. I think that's what's great about, you know, well, art in general, is there are certain nuances maybe to the piece that that kind of allow you to pull back on your faith, on how much of the knowledge of your faith, and say, oh, I remember this story, I remember this parable, right. I remember this. Tell us, there are other artists as well who are going to be part of the exhibit.
Yes, we have luminaries actually in the Philippine art scene, like Hermes Alegre. Of course, Salvador Ching, who started this Cristo circuit.
Right.
It's always as a piece there. You have Caloy Gabuco, Camille de la Rosa, Adi Kukingnan, so many others. There's you know, sculptures, right. We have mixed media presentations.
Yeah, it's interesting that there's obviously now digital art, some photography elements, I believe, as well,
right,
as
right.
sculpture. So it's really quite you know, broad spectrum of art forms and disciplines coming into this. I think it's nice that, you know, at the end of Lent, it's always about rebirth, you know. Has the process changed for you? What has, you know, as an artist and as somebody who takes part in this, is there something new you find every year in this
yes.
process?
Yes, of course. As an artist, we do evolve, mm-hmm. okay? Not only in the way we do our the application of techniques and the like, but you tend to see more. Just looking at the simpler things, you know, in art, it's always a rule that less is more.
Right.
Okay. You don't put too much details, and you get to distract the person from what you're trying to say. Mm-hmm. But here, you know, as we evolve, not only in our techniques, we also evolve in our visions. It depends also upon the beliefs that you have in you, your convictions. And as a Christian, we look to the symbolism of the butterfly.
Right.
Do you believe that? The butterfly. His three stages, the caterpillar, the caterpillar, and the butterfly. Uh-huh. And, well, it's very akin to the Christian life, where the ugly part, you're a caterpillar, you don't have much of this and that virtue, and then suddenly you go into hibernation, supposedly, you go soul searching, and then from there, you have this epiphany and become a new person.
Right.
And if you're going to do a parallel to the life of Christ, his public life was the caterpillar life, okay? He was there with the poor, the persecuted, mm-hmm. and then he went into the passion, and of course he was buried, that is the cocoon stage, mm-hmm. and suddenly...
Finally you emerge as the butterfly.
The message is
there.
Right.
Well, I think that's something for everybody to ponder. The exhibit will be on until the 24th.
Right.
It's something that we recommend everybody go out
yes,
and see
yes,
perfect
please.
For the Lent season. Thank you so much to Dan Lerma for joining us this morning and telling us all about this exhibit. Thank you, Dan.
Thank you very much, Paula.
Thank you.
Ginger.
All right, we now turn you over to Pinky. She's joined by CBCP.